Calcifying odontogenic cyst was first described by Gorlin in 1962. It is a cystic lesion which histologically shows an ameloblastomatous lining, along with ghost cells and focal calcifications. Calcifying odontogenic cyst is thought to arise from the reduced enamel epithelium surrounding the unerupted crown or from the remnants of the dental lamina. Since this lesion was first described, there has been much confusion with regards to the nature or behavior of this lesion and its terminology. So this has led to confusions as to whether this lesion could be a cyst, a tumor, a cystic tumor, or a lesion encompassing a cystic variant and a tumor variant. This lesion has also been termed calcifying cystic odontogenic tumor, calcifying ghost cell odontogenic tumor, dentinogenic ghost cell tumor, calcifying odontogenic lesion, and ghost cell cyst. So before we get into further details, let us brush through certain basics so that we can better understand what this confusion is all about and where this lesion stands in the most recent WHO classification of odontogenic cysts and tumors. A cyst is defined as a pathological cavity lined by epithelium having fluid, semi-fluid or gaseous content that are not created by the accumulation of pus. So cysts usually have a lumen, an epithelial layer lining the lumen, and a cyst wall or a capsule that basically comprises the connective tissue. A tumor, however, is a term that usually represents a neoplasm, benign or malignant, and is used to describe any solid tissue enlargement. Hence, tumors are solid neoplastic growths, unlike cysts, and do not possess a lumen. So is calcifying odontogenic cyst an odontogenic cyst or a tumor? Well, the 1971 and the 1992 WHO reports classified this lesion under the odontogenic tumor category. Interestingly, though classified as a tumor, the report described the lesion to be a non-neoplastic cystic lesion, fueling further confusion. However, the 92 report went on to state that the terms dentinogenic ghost cell tumor or odontogenic ghost cell tumor could be proposed for certain variants of calcifying odontogenic cyst showing a solid growth with ameloblastomatous lining, ghost cells, and dentinoid. Later, in the 2005 WHO report, this lesion was described as a benign cystic tumor or a cystic neoplastic lesion. This meant that though the lesion was cystic, its nature was that of a benign neoplastic tumor. The consensus report did not consider it to be a non-neoplastic cyst. Hence, the lesion was retained under the odontogenic tumor category, but it was renamed as calcifying cystic odontogenic tumor. Its solid variant, dentinogenic ghost cell tumor, however, was considered to be a distinct entity on its own. However, the most recent WHO report in 2017 states that most of the calcifying odontogenic cyst lesions are cystic in nature and rarely are they solid tumors. Also, they have a clinical course that is not aggressive and rarely recur. Hence, the report states that there is sufficient evidence to deem these cystic lesions as simple developmental cysts and not odontogenic tumors. Pathologists have agreed to go back to the lesion's previous terminology and call it calcifying odontogenic cyst. So, as per the most recent reports, calcifying odontogenic cyst stands to be a developmental cystic lesion classified under odontogenic cysts. So calcifying odontogenic cyst does not have a gender predilection and usually affects individuals in the second to fourth decades of life. The maxilla and the mandible have an equal predilection, but the lesion most often occurs in front of the molars in the incisor canine region. Clinically, the lesion usually presents as a swelling with a hard bony expansion. Individuals may rarely have pain and displacement of teeth. Calcifying odontogenic cyst may sometimes be extrusious and occur in the gingiva. Such lesions are around 4 cm in diameter, pink to red in color, resemble fibromas, and are smooth elevated masses occurring often in the incisor cuspid region. These lesions are unilocular lesions whose margins can be well circumscribed or poorly defined. Calcifying odontogenic cysts may on occasions also be multilocular lesions. 1/3 to half the cases are associated with irregular radiopacities. Sometimes the lesions are associated with odontomes, in which case the radiopacities could be denser. there may be tooth displacement, root resorption, and expansion of cortical plates. The extraneous lesions may cause superficial resorption of bone, manifesting as saucer-shaped radiolucencies. The histology features of calcifying odontogenic cyst are pretty characteristic and are quite straightforward to diagnose. In fact, this was the definition of calcifying odontogenic cyst given in the WHO 1992 classification. Oh yes, that is quite a huge definition, but this pretty much sums up the histology features of the lesion. So let's break this definition down to smaller chunks in order to understand the histology features. So calcifying odontogenic cyst is a cystic lesion. Hence, this would be the lumen, and this the epithelial lining, which is basically a palisaded layer of columnar cells with nuclei polarized away from the basement membrane. And the overlying layer of cells are pretty much epithelial cells too, but are separated from each other due to intercellular edema. In fact, they look very similar to the stellate reticulum seen during the cap stage of tooth development. Also to be noted is that this epithelial lining very much resembles that seen in ameloblastoma. So the second part of the definition says that there are masses of ghost epithelial cells that may be in the epithelial lining or in the fibrous capsule. The ghost epithelial cells may become calcified. So these ghost cells are basically eosinophilic epithelial cells that lack nuclei or cellular organelles. In fact, these cells may or may not retain their cellular outline, may become enlarged, ballooned, fuse with each other, and form amorphous sheets of eosinophilic material. No one still knows the nature of these cells. While there is a hypothesis that states that ghost cells may be a result of abnormal keratinization, there are also theories which propose that these cells may be a phenomenon of coagulative necrosis or abnormal accumulation of enamel proteins. Also, these cells have an affinity for calcification. There may be sometimes deposits of hyalinized eosinophilic material deposited below the epithelium. This is called dysplastic dentin or dentinoid. Well, this material is thought to be dentin-like material which arises as a result of an inductive effect of the odontogenic epithelium on the connective tissue. This is pretty much like ameloblasts inducing the dental papilla cells to become odontoblasts, which then secrete dentin. In some instances, calcifying odontogenic cyst may be associated with odontomas, which could be seen histologically as sheets of eosinophilic calcified material. And as far as treatment and prognosis is concerned, calcifying odontogenic cyst is usually treated conservatively by surgical enucleation, and the prognosis is very good. The lesion also very rarely shows recurrence. Calcifying odontogenic cyst sometimes could arise in association with an odontoma, for which the treatment would still be conservative.